A bit more, I will give you some passages in the Bible which says that we must rejoice always. The day I read that in the Word of God, I was like, God, you mean to say I'm supposed to be happy every single day? Yes, that's what it means. It says rejoice always, pray without ceasing. In all your ways, acknowledge God, give thanks to Him. A lot of people are serving the wrong God. The right and one and only God is good all around 360 degrees. That God, He wants you to do good, good, good every step of the way. He wants you to imagine good things towards your neighbors, your friends, anyone. So that's the God you want to know. So in your own personal search, you just in your closet say, God, I want to know the God that created me. I want to know the God that created the heaven and the earth. God, show up. Let me know you. How do I go about knowing you? You know, because we must be fulfilled. You must live every single day happy. You're supposed to live every single day happy. And, you know, good. I mean, happy every single day. Okay, let me also prickle or let me also put this to you. Do you know? Okay, no, let me put it this way. Okay, let's say you're happy, you're joyous, you know, you're bubbly, and somebody comes up to you and says something nasty to you, and within seconds you get upset, you become unhappy and sad. Have you wondered how, why that happened? The person did not hit you. He did not harm you physically. All he uttered was just some words. And it got to your heart. And it distorted your heart. And it deposited negative feelings inside. Don't you think there is power in the tongue? Even if you don't believe that, I stumbled into a passage in the Bible. I will, in other videos, make another video where I will refer to those passages so that you can go and study yourself. Just in case you don't believe in the Bible, it says the word, the verse says, there is power of life and death on our tongue, that whosoever uses it rightly will enjoy the fruits thereof. So, let's say you don't even believe in the Bible or God, but this word is in the Bible that there is power of life and death on your tongue. Okay, if that is not true, why would someone with words upset you? Why would someone with words make you depressed and unhappy? All they did was speak some words. All they did was talk you down. They were just words. And you were affected so deeply. Doesn't that make you believe that there is power on the tongue? And it's in the Bible, it's written there. I'm sorry for those of you that do not believe in the Bible. I'm sorry that I'm preaching a little, but these discoveries had set me free also. I used to be someone that used to think a lot before. I still think. What I mean is, I try to use my own understanding to decipher everything. But I realize that there's a limit to human thoughts. But there's a place where your thoughts can be monitored and directed aright. Have you ever wondered why would someone want to upset you? Maybe they don't like you. Why doesn't he or she likes me? Let me round up this video. All I want to say is words can mar or make you. The Bible says that you and I, human beings, were created in God's image. And when God created the heaven and the earth, he made on earth, he spoke words. So if he says he created you and I in his image, and he used words to create all the beautiful things on earth, and he's also saying in his word, the Bible, that there is power of life and death on our tongue, don't you think we can do things that God can do? No, we can't do above him, of course, but he has given us authority to do close to what he has done. But then how can we get to this stage if we don't know who he is? So all I'm trying to say is our tongue is powerful, and we need to also search out the creator that created us, so that we discover why and what purpose he created us for, so that we can be fulfilled. A happy man is fulfilled. Not temporary happiness. I'm talking of consistent happiness. When you discover this God, you will become totally in control of your emotions. Not that the negative man don't want to come in, but you will have authority to kick the negative out. Unlike the depressed people or the unhappy ones. Why the unhappiness entered? Because they absorbed that negativity. They accepted that negativity. They accepted that nasty words. But if you can dust it off you, it didn't get in. That means you're not affected. We all must get to a stage where words, negative words, must not affect us. So you can't do it by your own power. No, you must search the wisdom of God to be able to handle that. And the only place to get that is the Bible. I'm telling you, it is the Bible. I'm sorry if you don't believe in the Bible, and I'm preaching to you, please, for your own quest, please, you just go search, you pray that prayer, say any words, God, I want to know you, I want to live a fulfilled life. And I know once I know you, being that you created me, you have your divine purpose for me. So I want to know you. And the good thing about this God, he didn't impose on us. He gave us a choice to seek him out, to know him. Haven't you ever wondered why? Like, you see some people, they seem fulfilled, some don't. It's a choice. If you want to fulfill life, go search for the creator that made you in the first place. So guys, I could go on and on. I just want to share with you my little knowledge that I've gained so far. Otherwise, I used to think too much before. and little things used to bother me so quickly before, and I used to like get fearful, get unhappy easily, you know, like if like a friend or someone, okay, let's say when I was in the higher institution in the university, days that some friends don't say hello to me, I get a little upset. But we are being created differently. No human being must hold the key to your happiness. It's only God that created you should hold or has the key to your happiness. So when you render the key to your happiness to any human being, probably you're in love with somebody, and you allow that person to control your emotions, what if the person leaves this earth? What's gonna happen to you? He takes the key away with him. Now see why you cannot afford to let someone, a human being like you, hold the key to your happiness. No. You must be a standalone happiness, so that nothing will distort your happiness. It's not when you have plenty of money before you're happy. No. You must be happy consistently. You are supposed to also affect other people's lives with positivity. Again, let me just round off here, otherwise I could go on and on. But thank God I discovered myself. I'm still discovering. Not that I discovered, let me put it this way. That I consulted the creator that created me, the God, which way? And it's not a day's accomplishment. It's something gradual. Because the more you seek him, the more you get understanding of this world that you live in, the more he gives you insight into understanding people's mind, understanding why someone just dislikes you. Gives you the key over your emotions, so that nobody is holding you in bondage, meaning they control your emotions. No, it's not supposed to be. If that is the case, you can never be happy. You need to set yourself loose from that. Even if you're in love, maybe it's your husband, maybe it's your wife, maybe it's your boyfriend, girlfriend. Sense, we are created to be happy consistently. I saw it in the Bible. It says rejoice always, you know, but you must have a source that is causing your rejoicing. That's the Bible. That's Jesus that died for us. You must surrender your life to him for him. You need to go study the Bible. I don't want to preach too much. I just want to touch you. I want to make you. I want to set you out of that bondage of, you know, discouragement. And you know, when you're in control, you will not feel down when you lose or when you fail. Because you know that because you're created for a purpose, you're going somewhere. Failure does not determine who you are. It only makes you stronger. The day you accept that, then you're floating over challenges. Anyway, guys, I gotta go. So thank you for watching. Thank you. Thank you. Please subscribe, like, and share.